Hi guys, it's Khristina from Redefine Creative, and I have created a mood board challenge for you today, and this is for the Cheeky Studio design team. And so you saw the mood board there a second ago, and rather than going with the colors in the mood board this time, I decided to go with kind of this floral feel. So there's a very detailed, intricate, floral kind of feel to that mood board. And so rather than focusing on the colors, I decided to focus on those intricate floral details. And so I've taken this paper from the Good Vibes collection, and I have fussy cut all of these little leaves and vines. And I'm going to combine it with a bunch of the florals from Cheeky Studios, so from her Wildflowers set 3 and 4. And I'm going to create kind of a wreath around my page. So what I am doing right now is just trimming about a quarter of an inch off of my cardstock, and I'm going to put it on top of this diagonal background. And if you've been around my channel, you've seen that I use this on two different projects today. This diagonal stripe from Hustle and Heart is one of my absolute favorite papers. So I have an entire pack of 25 of that paper because I love to use it for this purpose. So I do a lot of layouts with black and white and pops of color. And so it works out perfectly for me as a matting on my background. And so I went ahead and I took this plate from my kitchen and used it to create a circle on my layout to show me where I want my wreath to go. And then I'm going to use my gold color shine, and I'm just going to add just a subtle mixed media around the outside of that circle. So I want there to be a little bit of gold detailing because I know in the back of my mind that I have some small gold accents that are going to go on this layout. So rather than waiting until the end and wishing I had this in the background or worrying about getting it on my photo and my leaves and all of that kind of thing, I'm just going to go ahead and put that on the background ahead of time and let it dry. And then I'm going to use this circle kind of as a guide to where I want to place all of these black and white flowers. So I'm just going to kind of play with the placement of where everything is, and I'm going to lay it all out for you, and then I end up going back off screen to glue it all down and changing things up a little bit. But basically, I just want to fill in this entire wreath. So I know that I'm going to have this bold black and white element with these leaves from Good Vibes. And then I'm also going to be bringing in those wildflowers from the Wildflower collection that's got the bright colors. So I'm making sure that I have this kind of continuous black and white circle, and then I'm going to add all my colorful accents. And you can see the photo that I'm using down in that left-hand corner. It's a black and white photo of my daughter, and it isn't the best quality of a picture. It's like a zoomed-in version of a full-length picture. So switching it to black and white does help with the quality of it to make it look a little bit better that way. This is a photo I've used previously in our family album, so this is one that's going to go in her individual album. And so I'm just going to go ahead and tuck in all of those little vines until I'm kind of happy with the arrangement and that it looks like a circle. And then I'm going to add those pops of color. So this is something that I definitely do frequently, where I have a big component of black and white, and then some really fun pops of color. And so I'm going to lay out where I want all of these little flowers and vines and leaves and things to go. And it really creates a unique look. And so although my page doesn't go necessarily with the color scheme in that mood board, it definitely goes with that really detailed, intricate floral theme that's going on. And so I'm going to use some Maggie Holmes Carousel collection, and I've grabbed that word, the little puffy, scripty word that says dream, and I know that I want that to be my title. And so then I'm going to go ahead and grab all of these chipboard hearts and stars that have the gold glitter on them. So this kind of goes back to where I had an idea in mind of where I was going to go with this layout before I started, so that I could get my mixed media element included without kind of being stuck after the fact. And so having that kind of plan and that idea in my head definitely made it easier to include the mixed media that I wanted to include. And so then I'm going to go ahead and add these little chipboard pieces into the layers of my wreath. And I like how that kind of takes it from more of a serious feel to a little bit more whimsical. So having these little glittered hearts and stars kind of mixed in and tucked under the layers just makes it look a little bit different. It kind of adds that fun little girl look to it. And I am going to tuck this heart in there so that it sits in the loop of the M on the title. And so I was just making sure I had that placed in the correct spot. And I am going to end up going back to that bottom left corner because you can see it's a little bit more flat than the rest of the circle. So I am going to go back at the end here and add a couple more little vines underneath to kind of round that out so it doesn't look quite so flat. And then I'm just kind of spending a little bit of time here thinking about what else do I want to accomplish on this layout, because I'm not about filling all of the space for no reason, but there is that large space inside my wreath that I feel like needs a little something, and I don't know for sure what that is at this point. So I'm trying to decide. I know I have one more big chipboard star down here, so I have that available to me. And so what I end up doing is going back to my wildflowers, and I'm going to go ahead and grab just a few that I can tuck in underneath my photo. And so this is going to kind of bring it all together. So I know that I want to use these three underneath my photo, and then I'm going to have one on some dimensional adhesive on top of my photo. And that's just going to tie in everything that's going on around the outside of the layout to what's happening in the center of the layout as well. And otherwise, I really don't feel like I need a whole lot of extra detail or tags or anything else, because there is a lot going on already with all of these floral elements. And sometimes, you know, simple with some white space or bold colors like this with white space is not a bad thing. It's actually a good thing, I promise. And so I'm going to add that bigger star tucked underneath that floral, and I really like the look of that. And then I am going to go back and add a couple of florals after I stop the camera in that bottom left-hand corner to kind of even it all out and make sure that it does look like a circle. And that is basically going to finish it. So I added a bunch of really delicate floral details. Combining that Good Vibes paper with the wildflowers from Cheeky Studio created a really fun look. And I hope that you will take some time and play along with this mood board as well, because I would love to see what you make. Bye!